This OU Highlight presentation is made possible by Kerr-McGee, a company of people helping people. The 1984 Sooners, the team that believed.
The Orange Bowl. The 1984 Sooners believed from the beginning they would be playing in this New Year's Night Classic, and they were right. Oklahoma went into the game ranked number 2 in the country with a shot at the national championship. It was a classic defensive struggle, complete with hard-fought comebacks. The Sooners clawed back from a 14-0 deficit. At the half, it was tied up again. Despite great effort and some outstanding individual play, on this night the Sooners fell short of victory. But Oklahoma had accomplished what few teams ever realize. The one-game disappointment can't take away from the season's worth of triumph. In getting to the Orange Bowl, the Sooners had overcome adversity and misfortune, ignored the doubts of others. The 84 Sooners, a team that believed. It was back to the wishbone in 84. New wrinkles on offense and new energy on defense. The first opponent to get a look at these changes was Stanford. OU was off and running with a 19-7 win. Pittsburgh was highly regarded and ranked in the top 10 when the Sooners traveled east for game 2. Oklahoma's young defense would set the tone early in the game, but in the process lost Kevin Murphy, one of the best players in the country, for the season. As they would demonstrate throughout the year, Oklahoma had other players who could step to the front and win. The Sooner offense kicked into gear in the second quarter and overwhelmed Pitt as newcomers helped lead the way. Lydell Carr rushed for 137 yards. And tight end Keith Jackson caught a touchdown pass. With the overwhelming win over Pittsburgh, the Sooners had reclaimed national attention as a power to be reckoned with. More people were now believing what the Sooners of 84 already knew.
Oklahoma! I love it. I love it. I love it, man. We were a total football team. I'm telling you, man, it was super job. We got a chance, like Danny Bradley told me. Hey, we're a different football team this year. We got a chance. Hey, got to get Baylor. I promise you we'd be 4-0. Hey, but you guys are the ones got to make it happen. We're going to make it happen. Coach.
The Baylor Bears got an old-fashioned licking when they came to Norman. OU busted the Bears 34-15, and they were ready to begin the Big 8 conference play against Kansas State. Oklahoma's defense spent the entire afternoon on the Owen Field turf taming the Wildcats. Kansas State could only scratch out 3 first downs and 19 yards rushing. There would be no caging Steve Sewell on this day. The senior from San Francisco rushed for more than 150 yards and caught 6 passes for 142 more. Oklahoma made it 4 in a row with their Big 8 opening victory over Kansas State. It was time for Texas. The OU-Texas shootout hadn't been rained on since the 1940s. It was all being saved for this day. And the annual Red River War has seldom seen a storm of controversy like the one produced in this one. The Sooners' advantage and talent began to show clearly, even through the downpour. Oklahoma came from behind in the second half to take the lead. Late in the game, the number one ranked Longhorns had 4 tries from the 2-yard line to take the lead. Each time, the Sooners stuffed the Horns. But with the aid of 2 missed calls by the officials, Texas was able to kick a game-tying field goal. The Sooners had earned the win. Texas was given the tie. Oklahoma left the Cotton Bowl still believing they were the best. And best described the Sooner defense in 1984.
Try to be best. 'cause you're only a man, and a man's got to learn to take it. Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you gotta hang tough to make it. History repeats itself, try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream. You're the best around, nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around, and nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around.
Oklahoma's defense was anchored by All-American Tony Casillas and backed up by a group which believed the only way to play the game is head up, smash him in the mouth football.
I gotta be proud, standing out in the crowd when the odds in the game by you. Try your best to win them all, and one day time will tell. When you're the one left standing there, you've reached the final bell. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down.
Being the best around means every team, every week, is gunning for you. That's just what Iowa State did when the Sooners traveled to Ames, Iowa. OU's offense was able to generate just enough points to win the game. Keith Stanbury preserved Oklahoma's lead with an interception late in the game. The Sooners were all smiles, but the win had been costly. Danny Bradley had to sit out the Kansas game with ankle and finger injuries. Backup Mike Clopton had been ruled ineligible. Without them, Oklahoma's offense was its own worst enemy. The pain of Oklahoma's only loss of the regular season was compounded later that night when defensive starters Keith Stanbury and Andre Johnson were lost for the season in a car accident.
We're going to get a real test of our character. We're going to be challenged in which way the direction of our football team goes. Our coaches believe in you. We're not going to quit on you. We don't want you to quit on yourself. You can't do that in this game. You've got to come back next week. Next week, and play, give great effort. Practice hard. You better back to the wall. Hell, we can come back and win it again, man.
Oklahoma's stretch run was counting on leadership, and a lot of that was provided by seniors Danny Bradley and Steve Sewell. Number 13 was a great offensive threat in 1984. Sewell was also a great example of the complete player. Whether he had the ball or was blocking, on the field or off, Steve Sewell was all class. For 4 years, he demonstrated what being a Sooner is all about.
I really think my career has flown by. I really think the most important thing is being a team player, and I think that's one of the reasons why our team has had this much success this year, is that a lot of other players have become team players. I really think I just like to be remembered as a really good person. I think that's more important than being a great athlete and, you know, just making a lot of touchdowns and a lot of yards and things like that. Just as a really good person and also a good football player will at least come second.
Number one, Danny Bradley was just that to Oklahoma in 1984. He was the key to the Big Red ignition, and when he was in the driver's seat, OU was in store for an exciting ride.
Great tradition. I think when I was coming out of high school, that was one of the main things that I had looked at Oklahoma. You get a great opportunity to experience a lot of things, a great atmosphere for football, a great university. You meet a lot of people that really is meaningful in your life, a lot of people that will help you along the line after your career here at OU, and it really means a lot to be a part of the OU program here.
Danny Bradley's injuries had been the focus of attention the week before the Missouri game. This was OU's make it or break it game. With their backs against the wall, Danny and his teammates responded to the pressure by making all the right moves. Offense rolled for more than 500 yards, and the defense did its thing, stopping the Tigers in their tracks.
Man, listen up. We became a great football team today. We became a hell of a football team. We have an opportunity now to go win three football games. I was worried about us for a while, but we proved something on offense today, man. Against a good football team, we beat anybody we play. I really do. You got to believe that. Because I've been worried about it. But we're not, man. Danny's back. Hey, we're back. Offensively.
Yeah.
And okay, so we're going to give game balls to Andre and Keith.
Yeah.
We're going to give game balls to the offensive line. Yeah. Hey, it's more fun this way, man. Great job, man. You've got to get ready to go now.
The Sooners climbed the mountains in Boulder, Colorado with ease. OU spent the afternoon tuning up for their annual dose of Big Red Bedlam. It was time for Nebraska. Chilly it gets in Lincoln, Nebraska. This confrontation of Big Reds is never a cold war. This year's showdown featured two defenses which made a habit of taking no prisoners, so something had to give, and it did. OU's offense ground out 26 tough yards to make the break count. It was an afternoon of little offense and a lot of defense. A classic straight up, hit 'em in the mouth, Sooner Husker matchup. Every offensive inch took a mile's worth of sweat. As usual, this game was out of this world and still far, far up in the air at the midway point. In the second half, Danny Bradley fired up the offensive machine when OU needed a score. Nebraska came back to drive 88 yards, but the Sooners owned the last 36 inches. Finally, it was Danny Bradley who turned the final corner and left the Cornhuskers staring at a dead end.
We went back out that second half. You had to believe. You had to believe. Because, man, we didn't help ourselves much. We didn't have the defense. Terrible field position, terrible field position. Couldn't make first downs. And all of a sudden, we make a play. Make a play. We score. Get it in. But I'm going to tell you something, man. That goal line stand just about takes it. Do it once in a lifetime.
We did.
You did it twice. The number one team in the country both times. Instead of getting one game ball defense, you get two game
OU versus OSU for a trip to the Orange Bowl. The Cowboys had never been to the Miami Classic. The Sooners had made the trip more than any other team ever. Oklahoma made sure both streaks remained intact. Oklahoma's defense ended the regular season the same way they had played all year. Oklahoma State rushed for a minus 4 yards. The Cowboys' highly regarded defense wasn't enough to keep OU out of the Big 8 throne room. The Big Red was back on top. It was supposed to be a building year at OU. Few had predicted Oklahoma to be a demolition squad to opponents. But predictions don't take into account what the players have inside, and that's where the 1984 Sooners had it all. They were a team that believed.
This OU highlight presentation has been made possible by Kerr-McGee, a company of people helping people.